Hey y'all, hey, I'm here with another video. So if you are a subscriber of mine, this probably will be really weird to you because I don't normally talk about like this show, whatever. If you're not, hey, hello, how you doing? If you see me moving around like this, I am like pregnant as all hell, so I'm on my bouncy ball. So I'm just trying to get in my little reps while I can. I am literally 1 month away from pushing this baby out, but I am here to talk briefly about Naked and Afraid Last Man Standing, aka Naked and Afraid XL 2.0, aka Naked and Afraid Everybody versus Jeff. Okay, I'm gonna try to like get a lot of my points together. I don't even really know where I want to necessarily start with it. I will say this, initially when I saw that the show came out, and yeah, I'm late on it, I don't really care, but I had saw it came out a couple months ago, but I was like, okay, I'm gonna watch that eventually. Then I saw it was on HBO Max, and I'm like, all right, bet the whole season is over, let me watch it all the way through. The reason I wanted to watch this show, it literally didn't even happen. Like the whole point of me wanting to watch this show is because it was called Last Man Standing, okay? Which is exactly what it sounds like to me. They even said it in the intro all the time. This is a competition for one person standing, and the person was gonna get $100,000. So I'm like, okay, bet. This is a different take on Naked and Afraid, because I do like Naked and Afraid. I like the regular one. I really prefer Naked and Afraid XL because they're like more so in a group and stuff like that. So I'm like, okay, cool, this is dope. However, what I thought would make this show dope did not make this show dope at all. They literally played this show like Naked and Afraid XL. And I'm mostly just gonna give a whole bunch of, I'm gonna complain mostly, specifically like to the producers of this show. Next season, when y'all come back, there needs to be a whole revamp of a lot of this stuff. One of the main problems with this show to me is that y'all didn't really enforce the rules that y'all gave. And when I mean the rules that y'all gave, I'm specifically talking about when it comes to staying in your group or staying in your camp or staying in your pair. So yes, when the show first starts off, it says that they have to survive 21 days with their partner. And if their partner taps, unless it's they're medically being tapped, then that means that that person goes home, right? So that didn't happen to anybody. Nobody tapped making somebody else go home. If they was tapped, it was because they was medically tapped. My issue with this show is, even in Survivor, right? Even in Survivor, which is an individual challenge, right? It's an individual competition, technically, but you have to survive in two different groups. Even on that show, you can't have people from Tribe A go over and chill and live with people in Tribe B just because they don't get along with the people in Tribe A. And that was my biggest problem with this show. Once they got out of their pairs and things like that, and it was like, okay, the pairs got to split up and go down to two different roads. Y'all didn't make it so that the people who was in this group had to stay with their group, and the people in this group had to stay with their group. The people in this group were just getting up and leaving and coming over here, spending the night over here, getting up, coming over here, chilling with these people over here. So it didn't make to me. And then even once we get down a little bit further and y'all made them come together as a group, then they split up again. Like, y'all never enforced the rules of people having to stay within their tribe or their group or whatever. And to me, that's what made it annoying. So let's get on to me what was the most annoying part. Like I said, this was supposed to be Naked and Afraid Last Man Standing. Y'all literally treated this like Naked and Afraid XL 2.0/ Naked and Afraid Everybody versus Jeff. And I say that because when I say Naked and Afraid XL, I mean in a sense of Naked and Afraid XL is everybody working together, right? Or you got like this group over here, they might come together and work together. It's literally about taking the all-stars of Naked and Afraid and putting them together and having them survive like maybe a little bit longer than they normally would. Cool. That's its own premise. But if the whole point of this show, like Jeff said multiple times, was for it to be a competition, why in the is everybody helping each other and working around like this is one big group? That was not the point of this show. That's why I was super annoyed. The point of this show was not for everybody to work together. And not understand that everybody is used to coming from an environment where it's like naked and afraid, naked and afraid, XL, where everybody works together. But that was not the point of the show. And I'm pretty sure when the producers put together the show, that wasn't what they wanted. That's why they put y'all in pairs, so that y'all could work in pairs together at first, then split up in groups and work a little bit. But at the end of the day, it's still an individual competition, and y'all did not do that. There was no type of sense of competition. The only competition was everybody versus Jeff. So let's get to everybody versus Jeff. I was so annoyed this entire time with everybody trying to make it seem like Jeff did something wrong. Now, is Jeff an ass? Absolutely. Is he arrogant? Absolutely. Does he run his mouth a little bit too much? Absolutely. And towards certain parts of this show, was he doing absolutely the most? Absolutely. But for y'all, specifically Walls, who ends up winning, which pissed me off, okay? Y'all made it seem like this man was just doing the craziest stuff in the beginning. When they first get there, and everybody pretty much had to spread out because they didn't get any tools. Everybody had to spread out and get their own cachet. And Jeff pretty much found a good majority of it, okay? First of all, everybody got mad because he was hyped about it and was yelling. That's Jeff. He's an ass. You should know that. But then, I think he came up to maybe like Waz and whoever his partner was. Maybe it was Gary, I think, at the time. Whoever Waz's partner was at the time. And Waz had a bow, an arrow. And Jeff had all of this stuff. He had all of these items. And he literally just came to him and said, well, I see that you have a bow and I have this knife or whatever. I see that you have two bows. So how about I give you the knife, you give me the bow. And from that one exchange, Jeff was just enemy number one. They made it seem like, Waz tried to make it seem like he told him that he was going off his granny or something like that. He literally was trying to barter. And then Waz got mad. And then in turn, everybody else was fucking followers, because that's what ended up happening. Y'all became followers, okay? And got mad because he didn't want to just give it to y'all. So Waz is like, well, we don't do that around here. I'm just gonna let people borrow my stuff. Okay, well, that's how you want to play the game. But to really make it seem from that point forward that Jeff was pretty much an asshole or a terrible person because he wanted to barter something, and then y'all kept saying, oh, he did this to himself, or we're doing the same thing. Once it got to the point where y'all didn't want to share food with him, is, oh, we're doing the same thing to you that you did to us. How? That's not the same thing. He didn't come to y'all and say, hey, can I take everything that you have and get nothing in return? Which happened a couple of times with a couple different people for y'all to get mad at. For example, when y'all end up getting the honey, right? And then Dan had came over with Chaney. I think that's her name. With Chaney to Gary and Waz's camp or whatever. And pretty much went and took a big ass piece of honeycomb and a big ass piece of the honey. And then just left. He did not provide anything. He did not give anything. What did y'all sit there and say? Waz like, I didn't like the fact that he did that. I see the type of person that Dan is. And even Gary was like, I don't like that shit. That was messed up for him to just come over here and take all of that. See, that's something Jeff never did. Jeff never came to y'all and just took something and didn't give anything back or come with the entitlement of, oh, this is mine. Every time he came to y'all, it was to give something to get something. Every single time. So I'm lost as to how he is the bad person when he was talking about bartering, not just giving. And then when people came to just take from y'all, he was gonna give and get versus just taking. But when people came and just took from y'all, then y'all had an attitude about that. At least at the bare minimum, Jeff in the beginning was willing to give something to get something. And I also want to say that I really hope that outside of this show, that's the type of people that all of y'all are. That all of y'all walk in the lane of, we share everything and it's not a give or take. I highly doubt that, but I hope that that's literally how the rest of y'all walk around here. My other problem, tying into this is that a lot of y'all was acting much, really much so holier than thou when y'all was on the same type of shit that Jeff was on, but y'all was just trying to disguise it. Waz and Matt being the two main fucking people. Matt, you want to sit up here and talk about how he's a liar and all of this, but then you sat up there and lied about finding some shit and not pretty much saying anything about it. This is my thing. If you're a good person, that means that you're a good person regardless of how other people act. That's what I feel a true good person is. So for y'all to sit around here and try to say that Jeff's a bad person, but all of y'all was out here acting shady, moving shady, and like Jeff ended up saying when all of them came to confront him, y'all was all being bullies. Facts of the matter was Matt, Dan, y'all was all, and even Steven at one point, y'all was all being bullies at one point. Absolute bullies. Bullies, 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 bullies. Saying, no, we're just treating you how you treated us. How? How? You're mad because he didn't want to give it to you. Y'all didn't come to him treating him the way that y'all would, that treating him the way that he treated y'all would have been y'all catching me and then coming to him and saying, okay, well, you want to know what? We see that you got all of this extra hide, because they felt some type of way about the hide situation. Would have been like, okay, well, we have this meat here. We see that you have hide or whatever. If we give you a piece of this Impala, would you give us the hide? That would be treating him the same as everybody else, because that's what he did to the rest of y'all. He did not come and just want to take. So I got annoyed mostly because y'all literally made Jeff the entire star of the show, to the point to where, first of all, he pretty much made it to the damn end, okay? He made it all the way up to be the third person or whatever. Last episode, last 20 minutes. Y'all made it to the point to where once he was eliminated, I no longer wanted to watch the show. And most people I saw did not want to watch the show anymore, even though there was only 20 minutes left in the show. Didn't care who won. Didn't give a fuck about none of that. Y'all made it so that he was literally the star. All y'all talked about was Jeff. That's all y'all did. That's all y'all did. And the crazy part is y'all talked all of that shit just for this man to end up at the end anyway. All of that nonsense that y'all talked, and all of it for him to end up at the end. I'm really annoyed that Waz won, because to me, Waz, next to Matt, was one of the most holier-than-thou people, but literally was an ass the entire time. The one thing I could at least respect about Jeff, and like I said, Jeff was not perfect. When he told Steven that he was lucky he was going, he didn't throw his stuff in there, that was messed up. There was a lot of messed up things that Jeff did. But my problem is that, my thing with Jeff is at least Jeff stood in the fact that he was an ass. He never tried to sit up there and try to make it seem like I'm out for anything other than trying to win this competition. He made that very clear from the beginning and held on to that to the time he left. The rest of y'all tried to make it seem like y'all was just all hokey pokey and y'all just wanted everybody to fucking win, when at the end of the day, y'all was all being selfish but covering it up. Okay? So, for example, like I said, even when it came to Waz, you did that a couple times to people. You was being extremely shady. And my problem was that you think that you everybody's daddy. Like, you got kids at home. Was nobody out here your kid? The way that you talked to Gary when Gary had to try to come to y'all with Sarah and was like, hey, I know that y'all feel some type of way about Jeff, but the way that y'all are treating him, y'all are making our lives a living hell. And he didn't even get to get it out without Waz trying to cut him off and tell him what to do. Then when Sarah had went and caught a damn fish and came back to the camp with y'all and was like, oh, well, I gave Jeff part of the fish, and Waz wanted to snap on her like, you don't give him anything because we decided as a group we're not going to give him anything. Like she said, I caught that fish, not you. You don't get to tell me who I give something to. Now, with your piece of Impala that Gary end up giving a piece to him, you can be mad at him about that because you're the one who caught that. But you don't get to tell me the work that I put in, what it is that I get to do with that. And Waz had a fucking real bad habit this whole damn season of telling people what they could and could not do, specifically when it comes to Jeff. And it was annoying. Even I felt at one point, maybe it was like, I think maybe Steven or Dan had caught something, but Waz just so happened to be around. And once they got it, it was like, well, yeah, we definitely not giving that to Jeff. Who were you to say that? You didn't catch it. You did not catch it. You did not catch it. And you didn't care about making sure everybody else was good. You simply cared about getting that man out of here. That's what you cared about. And I love Steven. Steven ended up apologizing at the end, and I like rock with him for that. But even the way that he, what he did to Sarah, now, off of now what Steven said, I didn't even get mad at that, because that's the rules that Jeff was going by, which is that this is a competition. So when Sarah came and said, Steven, you fucked me over by being on my trail, in all reality, no, he didn't, because this is the competition and he found it before you did. But if we're playing off of the rules that you guys set, the minute that you saw Sarah, she was right, Steven. You should have left off that trail and went somewhere else, and you did not. Y'all kept picking and choosing, and even saying throughout the season, which was pissing me off, y'all wanted to pick and choose when y'all want to treat things like a competition, and then when it's time to all come together. Y'all needed to stick to one damn thing, and that's what I said. As much as Jeff wasn't ass, at least he was consistent, and this is a competition and this is how I'm gonna play the game. Y'all all was picking and choosing when y'all wanted to do things and when y'all didn't want to do things. Just like how when Jeff and Gary was having a whole problem with the rap, like Gary ended up saying, you have an attitude with Jeff, cool, fine, but why you gotta now take it out on me? Because I thought we was all cool. I thought we was all sharing. I thought we was all in this together. And y'all went and y'all got food and y'all didn't share with Gary because of the fact that he was sitting next to Jeff and he didn't have any choice. Y'all are all full of shit. Every single last one of y'all pissed me off. Chaney pissed me off. Sarah pissed me off. All of y'all pissed me off. And specifically because most of y'all can't even think for yourselves. Y'all heard one to two people say something, and then y'all all just jumped on the bandwagon of being on his side. Because for the most part, Jeff didn't really do anything to anybody. The only person I can honestly say that Jeff really did something wrong to was Steven. And that's because he told him he's lucky he didn't throw his stuff in the water. Everybody else was straight mean girling and bandwagoning off of Waz and off of Matt. And you want to know why y'all did it? Because they was the two strongest people. Specifically, y'all was on Matt's D.I.C. because of the fact that he was a good hunter. Mind you, he didn't even catch it this whole season. But y'all strategically did that. He didn't do nothing to y'all other than the fact he didn't give anything to y'all. And if this is supposed to be a competition, he doesn't have to give anything to y'all. Y'all lucky he came to y'all bartering versus going and stealing your stuff. Y'all made me mad this whole season. This season was dumb as hell. Like I said, if y'all come back next season, the rules need to freaking change. There makes no sense that y'all literally separated them into groups multiple times, but every time they're in a group, separate groups, now the entire group A is going over here to be with group B and leaving Jeff by himself. I don't even care that y'all left Jeff by himself. That's not the point. The point of the matter is that the show would have been more interesting and would have made more sense if y'all made people stay in their respective groups. What was the point of splitting the groups up if y'all was just gonna allow everybody to be back in the same group anyway? That's why I said, for all of that, you might as well have made it Naked and Afraid XL 2.0. Literally, it defeated the whole point. As I said, with Survivor, just because there's one person in the tribe that doesn't get along with everybody, that doesn't mean now that everybody in tribe B can go and hang with everybody in tribe A and leave this one person by themselves. No, the whole point is that you keep this dynamic together so that you can see how they work around it. Not just let people do whatever it is that they want to do. This is a competition, as Jeff said multiple times. Competition. And y'all picked and chose when y'all wanted to be a competition and when y'all didn't. And it's fool and it's bullshit. And then for y'all to get to the end and pretty much say that everybody but him deserves it, I find that weird, because every single other person around here got extra help, got food, got assistance, except him. And he still made it to the final three. So what the fuck does that say about the rest of y'all? How didn't he earn it then? Make that make sense. He didn't steal from anybody. He didn't take anything from anybody without asking. He didn't not contribute at all and still get the reapings. Yes, y'all gave him food one damn time. But again, y'all didn't have to if y'all didn't want to. If y'all wanted to treat him the same, you would have bartered and said, hey, we got this piece. You seeing how you want to play the game like this, you give us this and we'll give you that. That would have been playing the game the same way as him. But there was plenty of people. I'm sorry, I like Steven and everything like that, but all the way up until they got into their separate groups, for real, neither Steven or Chaney did anything. A lot of y'all people did nothing to contribute to the group and still got something. At least Jeff had to get up and get out and get something on his own or with his partner. Y'all disgust me, and I'm annoyed that y'all made, and as much as it was entertaining to a degree with Jeff, it was really annoying to me that this whole season, literally 10 episodes, was wrapped around all of y'all versus Jeff. It made it annoying, and it made it annoying that all of y'all wanted to sit up on a high horse and try to make it seem like this man did something super, super crazy by wanting to barter with y'all. Do better next time, executives. Do better next time, producers. Do better. And Waz and Matt, y'all both full of it. Both full of it. Including you too, Dan. Full of it. Full of it. Even at the end, when Matt was pretty much about to go home, and Dan's like, nobody wants you over here. And guess what? Matt still said bye to him. Y'all literally went out y'all way, like Jeff said, to take things personal, because that's what y'all did. Y'all was taking things personal, and y'all was being mean girls, point blank, period. Was Jeff being an ass? Of course he was. Of course. But was y'all being mean girls and acting like this was fucking high school and clicking up against somebody? Yes, you sure were. You sure the hell were. I'm over it. This season sucked as far as I'm concerned. Do better next time.